We are devastated to have to cancel a second Met season in a row. You know, ABT is America's national ballet company, but New York is our home, it's our headquarters, and we eagerly anticipate every spring returning to the Metropolitan Opera House to perform for our loyal fans. It is a tradition that ABT has had since 1976. We've had regular seasons at the Metropolitan Opera House. So to have to cancel for a second year in a row due to the ongoing pandemic to protect the health and safety of our artists, our staff, our crew, and of course our audiences is just, it's truly devastating. At the same time, we know that we will be back soon, hopefully in live performances in New York in the fall. And in the meantime, delivering our artistry to audiences around the country and our fans in New York City via digital and hopefully some live outdoor socially distanced performances as the spring and summer arrive. It's just too hard to get enough people together behind the scenes to safely rehearse. We need public assembly. We need close physical contact, not only to perform, but also to bring people together to rehearse these epic ballets.
So Cara, I mean, it's fair to say that many of our audience here are patrons of the arts, and especially the ballet in New York City as well. Financially speaking, how exactly will this impact the ABT? How will it impact your performers and all of the other people associated with the entire company? This is huge because it means that a season is perhaps not, I mean, it's physically not there. But what exactly does that mean for your health, financially speaking, going down the line?
Sure. It's major. We rely on earned revenue. We have no ticket sales, no touring fees now for 2 years in a row for 2020. And the lion's share of our earned revenue is now gone for 2021. At the same time, we continue to provide exceptional education programs and to generate some earned revenue that way, as well as to train the next generation of artists around the country. And we also have managed to inspire generous philanthropists, individuals, foundations, and corporate sponsors, corporate brands that want to align with us and support our ongoing creativity through crisis. So philanthropy has really been sustaining us and will continue to sustain us during this time until we can return to standing ovations and robust ticket sales at the Met and at our other theaters around the world.
All right, so Cara, this is a big one, and I know because I love seeing live performances as well. What do you think? Do people come back to live theater, live events, the ballet in the coming years because we are over the vaccine process and into this recovery phase for the U.S. and world economy?
I think so, Dom. I think people will come rushing back once it's safe to do so. I think we don't only miss the hugs, the handshakes, the family gatherings. I think we miss that communal experience, the power of sharing live performing arts. And I look forward to the day when our theaters are once again packed. And in the meantime, I think that we're developing a lot of new skills, a lot of new storytelling techniques on new platforms. And so I think that we will continue to reach the widest possible audience and to make this art form and all of the performing arts more accessible on digital and hopefully in outdoor venues so that it's not only the people who can make it into the red velvet seats of the Opera House, but also fans and aspiring artists around the country who can have access to companies like ABT and our programs.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.